Plain City Life. You know, it was a while ago that we launched this series, Me and My Big Mouth. And we launched it by considering what Jesus says in Matthew 12, verse 36, where he says, you must give an account on Judgment Day for every idle word that you speak. And I can remember years ago talking to a teenager who had gotten plenty idle with the words that he was posting online. And I pointed to that verse, and his reply was, those words don't count. And man, if only that were true, because I'm not sure there's a place that we get ourselves in more trouble with our words than through a keyboard. It's so easy for us in the digital world and our words on it for that to feel disconnected from the word, the Bible. After all, you might think, what could a book that was written some thousands of years ago have to say about our digital dialogue online today? Well, the answer is a lot. Matter of fact, in the book of Proverbs, you can comprise what I'll call the six social media commandments. You know, they've helped me immensely, and I hope they help you. First is this: thou shalt remember silence and keep it handy. You know, there was a time, not long ago really, when you would hear news or information, and you might actually say, wow, that's interesting. But you know, I don't know enough about that to have an informed opinion. But the temptation of our culture today and the pull of social media that we give into again and again is that we need to pick a side, us versus them, set up a debate over every single thing that happens. But sometimes wisdom is most evident in silence. That's why thou shalt remember silence. Keep it handy. Remember it, that it's useful. A verse that has served me throughout my life is Proverbs 17:28. It says, even fools are thought wise when they keep silent, and with their mouths shut, they seem intelligent. Look, thank God that we live in a country with free speech and the freedom to express our beliefs and ideas. But as the Apostle Paul says in his writings, just because something is permissible doesn't make it beneficial. And sometimes, as Solomon is saying, wisdom is best revealed in keeping your mouth shut. You know, the reality we walk in online is that the more frequent we post, often the more foolish it's prone to get. And sometimes, even violent. Yes, violent. That's why the second social media commandment, thou shalt not kill. And maybe you say, wait a second, isn't that one of the like actual Ten Commandments? Yeah. And maybe you're saying, why are we talking about killing when we're talking about just posting and talking on social media? Well, Proverbs 12:18 says that there is one who's rash words are like sword thrusts, but you know, the tongue of the wise brings healing. I think we all know that social media's posts can push, provoke, and prod, but we're also swinging a psychological sword. So before I post, am I hurting or am I healing? You'll struggle to find any passage in scripture that supports the former. And as it says elsewhere in Proverbs, in the Message version, it says, hey, words kill or words give life. And you choose every time you post. That's why I shall not kill. But you know, some would say, well, I got a carry permit for the sword of the spirit, and I'm posting that truth. And I keep this thing locked and loaded at all times. That's why the next commandment is thou shalt check your intent. Proverbs 15:1 says, a gentle answer deflects anger, but harsh words make tempers flare. What makes something authentically Christian is not just its truth, but its tone. Not just its content, but its intent. Is it a gentle answer or is it harsh words? Because more often than not, our tone is just as important as the truth we share. You've heard it said, check yourself before you wreck yourself. You should check your intent before you wreck your content. Look, the Apostle Paul in Scripture doesn't just encourage us to share truth. Paul tells us that we should speak the truth in love. He says, you could possess all knowledge, win every argument, dominate every debate, silence those fools with scripture. But if you do it without love, you're a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. In layman's terms, you aren't anointed. You're annoying. Nobody cares about your truth if it's laced with the wrong tone. Let your words be laced in love, even online. So how do we love even online? Good rule to follow. Thou shalt seek to understand. Seek before you speak. You know, some of my favorite people on Al Gore's internet are the people who comment on an article or a video without reading or watching it. Their itch to share their opinion is so strong, and their self-control so small that they don't even check to see what's in the article or video first. There isn't a single ounce of seeking and understanding. But Proverbs 18:2 says, "Fools have no interest in understanding. They only want to air their own opinions." And here's the thing, when it comes to opinions, social media has created this forum where people think every opinion holds as much weight as another, but they don't. Somebody recently commented criticism on my Facebook page, and to be honest, I had to look up, who is this? So you know how much their comment and criticism meant to me? Not a lot. You know what I said in reply? Not a word. Because not all opinions are created equal. And opinions, outside of relationship, they're often nothing more than like noise pollution. But we persist on doing just that because we like what's easy. And it's far easier to type an opinion at somebody than walk alongside them through life. So we post often what amounts to noise pollution, or what Solomon would call folly, and then we keep it moving. So seek to understand. Oh, and understand this, thou shalt not RSVP to every argument. You know, a really freeing stance in life is I don't have to attend every argument that I'm invited to. Someone posts something that runs counter to my convictions and I feel that boiling of offense, or someone antagonizes me, I can put no on the RSVP. Proverbs 19:11 says, sensible people control their temper. They earn respect by overlooking wrongs. You want to earn respect? Overlook some wrongs. At least don't be so easily triggered. Because to take that verse in the opposite direction, you can lose respectability by being outraged by everything you come across. And Christians online can be some of the most easily triggered people around. And then you consider the math in that proverb. We become the boy who cried wolf. Hard to respect, even harder to take seriously. And similar to this, but different, thou shalt not invite yourself into others' arguments. It's so easy to do on social media. But Proverbs 26:17 says, interfering in someone else's argument is as foolish as yanking a dog's ears. You know, there are people who step into an online debate or argument from left field, call it post-policing, call it the impulse to comment on everything, but to bring correction with people we barely know in conversations that you've invited yourself into. I mean, sure, you can do it, but just know it carries the same success rate as pulling a pit bull's ear. And if you're the victim of somebody who wanders in with foolishness, you know, it also says in Proverbs, answer not a fool, right, according to his folly, or you yourself will be just like him. So lastly, don't feed the fools. Don't feed into the foolishness. Don't feed the trolls. Hurt people, hurt people. And social media is a forum where people do just that again and again with their words. Hurt people, hurt people. And foolish people hurt people back. But love people, love. The fruit of the Spirit in us is love. So I'll close with the words of the legend Charles Spurgeon. He says, next time you're inclined to find fault with everybody and set your brethren by the ears and create a general scuffle, I pray you let the chimes ring out, but the fruit of the Spirit is love. Whenever you're bent on the growling business, pause a while and hear Scripture admonish you, the fruit of the Spirit is love. Our words count. The fruit of the Spirit is love, even online. So let's let our words be a part of the greatest commandment given by Jesus, to love. I know I love you guys. God bless. Take care.